This brief presentation will introduce you to some of the main points of our research paper, Work of the Unemployed, an inquiry into individuals' experience of data usage in public services and possibilities for the agency. I am Naja Holten Møller, assistant professor at the University of Copenhagen, and together with my co-authors, I present this research, Trine Rask Nielsen, at the University of Copenhagen as well, and Christopher Dantec from Georgia Institute of Technology. The study shows how approaches such as design fiction are effective at including marginalized communities through changing the conditions for design, showcasing the fictional outlook and how the design experience can be disempowering, if not qualified through deeper critique. The paper contributes to agendas on design justice. We set up this fiction to address power dynamics in public services and job placement more specifically. We wanted to understand how individuals experience the use of data about them through a fictive app, speculating what future datafied job placement could look like. So the context for this study is Danish job placement. And this paper builds on a longer ethnographic fieldwork across two municipal job centers, which has been ongoing for a couple of years by now, focusing on casework and citizen strategies for exercising authority and personal autonomy, social welfare. The overall question we explore in this paper is what happens once new forms of data become institutionalized and designed, potentially invisibly, into the decision-making infrastructures that gatekeep access to public services. What we see in this picture is the citizen portal for unemployment services the way it looks today. Today, public services increasingly presume a new and more active role for individuals to play in datafied society, such as self-services. However, while design efforts attempt to include stakeholders, such attempts are often limited to professional perspectives. Little is known about how unemployed individuals who are subject to these solutions experience increasing use of data about them. The design fiction of this paper that we call JobNet Trace is a possible yet fictional scenario, important to say. It's an app for unemployed individuals' work that they have to perform by managing how data about their lives, including new uses of social media data, et cetera, are shared in order to make themselves eligible for support, as we will see demonstrated in this next clip.
Imagine a platform, JobNet Trace, a further development of an already existing Danish job placement platform called jobnet.dk, but now it's an app with self-checking elements. On this platform, individuals can apply for particular services and job placement offers, and this way support is earned as the unemployed individual uploads self-checking data. Personal data, like GPS data, data from social media, or health data. An algorithm classifies the performance of unemployed individuals based on the data they upload. This way, the algorithm becomes a central mechanism for accountability and control instead of the caseworker, who acts as an arbitrator between the individual citizen and the algorithm.
So to understand how individuals experience data usage in this setting, we set up four online focus groups and then invited 20 individuals enrolled into job placement to reflect on the app and the fictive scenario. And they were then invited to debate with each other across these four questions. What do you think of the fictional app shown in the video and illustrated here? What information about you do you see as being your personal information? And what information about you do you want to share with the job center? And in what situations? Why and why not? When do you think it's okay for the job center to collect information about you if you get something in return? And in what situations? What is important to you in terms of being able to trust the job center's use of information about you and in what situations? Here we see some examples of the responses we got. Our first finding shows that individuals experience use of scores as illegitimate and stressful, as we hear from one individual stating. A score of one success would add yet another stress factor to being unemployed. It would not be motivating as it's probably intended, because I would feel pressured to always keep an eye on my score. I miss an elaboration on what this score is based on. Secondly, we find that our participants neither perceive data about the individual as a commodity, nor civic duty, as we hear from another individual in the study. Income, of course, they need to know because it's fair that I still receive support. Educational background, yes, then hopefully they can help me in my job search. Health data, yes, well, if I'm entitled to sickness benefits. The rest, absolutely not. Consider it surveillance. Finally, intention matters for the kinds of data individuals share we find in the study. One individual reflects, trust and job placement can be increased if you, as an unemployed, is met with care and interest, as a human and individual, and not just a number in a row. It is, in fact, the most important thing that could be done differently in job placement. What we learned from this study is also that data sharing is decided within the specific relation, and in this way, data are folded into the hierarchical interactions among caseworker and individual within the larger context of job placement and other kinds of public authorities involved in the production of data about the individual. From this perspective, unemployed individuals have legitimate interest in the design of algorithmic public services. Understanding data as something that may be commodified critically shapes how we should make individual experiences a resource for designing service provisions, our case here shows. Data usage, we find, is experienced by unemployed individuals as more or less reasonable, but their assessment of the reasonableness runs into gaps. The non-technical public understands agency as the power to take control of usage of data, distinct from power over the conditions and individual impact. Thus, designers of public services need to be attentive to the limits of how individual agency can be exercised in conditions that allow it. To sum up, what this scenario means for design of algorithmic public services is that we need to be less concerned with the materialities of data and more concerned with the materialities of policy, regulation, and the state as it institutionalizes and it codes itself into digital infrastructures of decision-making in public services. This study shows such, or how approaches such as design fiction are effective at including marginalized communities through changing the conditions for design. We thank all the individuals that were involved in the study for their engaged participation in the focus groups. We also want to extend our appreciation to the caseworkers and job centers that invited us to ethnographically study their practices, which has been the foundation for this work. This work was supported by the Innovation Fund Denmark. Thank you for listening.